There are so many ways to integrate our Adobe and Khan Academy activities into your instruction. When deciding which implementation approach may be best for you and your learners, consider these questions. Where do your students typically have access to the internet and digital devices? In your classroom, at your school or campus, or at home? How much synchronous in-class time do you have? How much time do your students spend doing independent or homework? What kind of learning do you and your students typically do when together? Do you spend it learning core concepts or doing collaborative or discussion-based activities? There are no wrong answers here, just variables to help you decide how and when you may want to integrate Adobe Creative Activities and Khan Academy content into your curriculum. Our activities were designed with ultimate flexibility and adaptability in mind to suit almost any style or modality of learning. In this video, we'll give you some examples of the first main implementation approach inside of your class. In the next video, we'll focus on outside of class implementations. In class, you can use either Khan content or Adobe Creative Activities daily as bell ringers, do nows, or exit tickets. Weekly during dedicated times, such as Khan Wednesdays and Creative Fridays. This might include creative shareouts of student learning, think pair shares, or other brainstorming, collaborative, or discussion-based activities. Or scaffolded as mid-lesson or unit class formative assessments or checks for understanding. What about larger projects? A few times a month, before a midterm or test, you could use Adobe and Khan Academy as an end-of-unit study session, giving students creative and engaging ways to practice synthesizing and communicating their knowledge to prepare for a test. Or alternative or additions to existing summative assessments with project and performance-based options. These outcomes can also build into year-long student portfolios of work for college or careers. Let's hear from educators who have implemented and adapted Adobe and Khan Academy materials for their own in-class needs.
We know using the new skills and concepts they're using creatively can be really motivating, particularly for the least motivated students. One thing you might do is preview the Adobe content or the digital extensions as the way that you're going to apply these skills and concepts for students at the beginning of class to serve as that motivation. Then you can introduce your content as usual. You can use Khan Academy to provide instruction and practice on those skills, either in class or as homework. And as students demonstrate mastery on Khan Academy, they can then move on to the Adobe content to apply those skills and knowledge in a new way.
See it and do it. So watch a Khan Academy video and then quickly open up a video tool in Adobe, whether it's Spark or Rush, and now recreate that video. Teach a concept showing what you learned in a Khan Academy video, but perhaps using your own story or your own example or your own illustrations to really demonstrate that you understood the concepts and information that you watched, but you've also internalized it and made it your own.
Using Khan Academy to supplement different lectures that we do because it provides so much more information. And sometimes I'll have students who really want to go in depth about a certain topic, and I can point them to Khan Academy, knowing that Khan Academy is going to have great resources to help them dive deeper into that specific subject area. And with Adobe, I love using Adobe in the classroom because I get to see the creativity of my students.
I enjoy using Khan Academy and Adobe in the classroom with my students as a means to guide students through content and collaboration. When students watch Khan Academy videos together, it gives me the opportunity to check for understanding right away and to clarify any misunderstandings or misconceptions. And then I can help students through the process of collaborating or through the process of creating something using the Adobe tools.
So one strategy that I use is asking students to learn and practice the concepts on Khan Academy, and then going ahead and making presentations and videos explaining the same concepts to their peers. Because the best way to learn is if you can teach it to somebody else. And in this process, the students themselves realize their own gaps. I'm able to see their own misconceptions and then later on remediate it.
I can consider the needs of a particular group of students and how I might adapt these lessons to fit the needs of my particular students.